السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي فضل سيدنا ومولانا محمدا على العالمين جميعا، وأقامه يوم القيامة للمذنبين المتلفسين الخطائين الهالكين الشفيعا. فصلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى كل من هو محبوب ومرضي لديه صلاة تبقى وتدوم بدوام الملك الحي القيوم. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن العظيم والفرقان الحميد: والذي جاء بالصدق وصدق به أولئك هم المتقون. صدق الله مولانا العظيم وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين والمطمئنين إلى يوم الدين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم صلوا عليه صلاة وسلام عليك يا رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليك وسلم. Brothers and sisters, last Friday we went through life of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. So I remind you, last week, Friday, that on the 22nd of Jumad al-Ukhra, he passed away. So I'm continue on my same topic. Today also I want to go through his life and I want to reflect something, some lesson from his life, you know, so may me and you can understand something about our lifestyle. Love and respect of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam is most important part of our life, as you know. Allah Almighty says, inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashshiran wa nadhira wa da'iyan ilayhi bi idhnihi sirajan munira. In another place Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashshiran wa nadhira لتؤمنوا بالله ورسوله وتعزروه وتوقروه وتسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا. O Muhammad, we sent you as a Bashir, as a Nadir. Bashir means good newser. Nadir means warner. So Allah says, O Muhammad, we sent you as a Bashir, as a Nadir. Why? لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. So may people believe in Allah and His Messenger, عَزَّ وَجَلْ وَصَلَّ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. And then, وَتُعَزِّرُوهُ وَتُوَقِّرُوهُ. So may they respect you, honor you, and glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala morning and evening. Is in very clear hadith, Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam says, hadith is there in Bukhari, La yu'minu ahadukum hatta akuna ahabba ilayhi min waladihi wa walidihi wa nasi ajma'in. Aw kama qal sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. None of you can be a true believer until I am dearer to you more than your family, your children, and entire humanity. Brothers and sisters, many times we claim to be a lover of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, but when it coming to action, when it coming to implementation, we don't have anything to prove it, to show it in our life. Because love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not only saying I love my beloved, you know. The words only, this is not sufficient to prove and show that love. regard of this love of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Look at the life of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an. Then we will understand what is true love of beloved, what is true love of Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, what is real and true respect of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, what is real ta'zeem and tawqeer and ta'zeer of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala was a great lover. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حُبِّبْ إِلَيَّ مِن دُنْيَاكُمْ ثَلَاثْ الطيب والنساء وقرة عيني في الصلاة. Somebody sleeping in the bath, you know, just I need your attention because today is Friday and public holiday, so after Jummah you can go and sleep comfortably, you know. So but for short time I need your attention. No, brothers and sisters, it is very important, you know. Many times we coming to the masjid and we going back is nothing, you know, we never take nothing, no lesson. So that's why I need your attention, please. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, حُبِّبْ إِلَيَّ مِن دُنْيَاكُمْ ثَلَاثَ الطِّيبُ وَالنِّسَاءُ وَقُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. There are three things are beloved to me from your dunya. الطيب, first is fragrance. والنِّسَاء, and pious woman. وَقُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ, and the coldness of my eyes is in salah. When Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that, immediately Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala got up and said, حُبِّبْ إِلَيَّ مِن دُنْيَا سَلَاسْ أَيْزًا النَّزْرُ إِلَى وَجْهِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam وَإِنْفَاقُ مَعْلِي عَلَى رَسُولِ اللَّهِ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam وَالْجُلُوسُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. This is true love, subhanallah. Immediately he said, حُبِّبْ إِلَيَّ مِن دُنْيَا سَلَاسْ أَيْزًا O Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, there are three things beloved to me also from the dunya. Then he says, An-nazru ila wajhi Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. First is to see the bright and beloved face of Messenger of Allah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And second, wa infaqu mali ala Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to spend my money and my wealth upon Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And third, wal julusu bayna yaday Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to sit in gathering of Messenger of Allah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. These three things are beloved to me also from the dunya. Subhanallah. This is true love, you know. Not only to say I love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfilled his wish and he accepted his dua and his supplications, you know. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed him three of them, subhanallah. Entire life saw the beloved face of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And even after the death got place, he got place just next to Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfilled his wish. And how much wealth he spent on Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, me and you cannot understand and cannot put it in words. But Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, he says in Hadith Sharif, ما نفعني مال أحد قط ما نفعني مال أبي بكر أو كما قال sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, none of your wealth benefited me like wealth of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala. As much his wealth benefited me, none of your property and money and wealth. And whatever all of you spend on me, I returned them back. But whatever Abu Bakr spent on me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will return him in the day of judgment.
Subhanallah.
Whatever Abu Bakr spent on me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will return him back in the day of judgment. Can you imagine how much wealth he spent on Messenger of Allah? One day, as I mentioned last week, he brought all his property to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, for my family and for my children, I left only Allah and his Messenger. You know, when today, people coming to us to for some donation
towards religion and affairs of the masjid, you know, first thing we look at our pocket. First thing we look at our pocket. If 100 I will give, 100 will be less in my pocket, you know. I will go back to home empty. Believe and trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala something, you know. If you will spend something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I guarantee you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more. But first is belief, faith, and trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One day Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked by a messenger that, O Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell me some act that after doing that I can enter in paradise. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa tawakkal ala Allah, and put your trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you will do these two things only, inshallah you will enter in paradise. So respected brothers and sisters, Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala has so deep and intense love and respect with the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Few days before his death, he inquired from Sayyidah Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha that, O my daughter, tell me how many clothes were given in the coffin of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Few hours before his death, Sayyidah Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha said, three. Three clothes Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given in his coffin. Then Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala says that, O Aisha, O my beloved daughter, I also should be given coffin in same piece of clothes, no anymore. I should be given coffin in same three clothes in which Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given coffin, because I want to follow my beloved after the death in my coffin also, how I used to follow his footsteps in my life. Subhanallah. This is love. Only I love my beloved, I love my beloved. This is not a sufficient for to show and to prove and to show that love in practice. So respected brothers and sisters, Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala was a true lover of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. After that, Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala said to Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala that, O Aisha, if I will die in night, don't wait for day. If I will die in night, don't wait for day, because that moment is so beloved to me, in which will make me close to my beloved Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the grave. Subhanallah. He says that moment is so beloved to me, which will make me close to Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam in my grave. So if I will die in night, don't wait for day and bury me as much fast you could bury me. So respected brothers and sisters, Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala was not ordinary person. He was a great companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He was a great and in the high in all the companions, you know. The companions, how many companions approximately at the time of the death of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam? 124,000 companions, Sahaba took part. How many? At the time of the death, in the janazah of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, 124,000 Sahaba companions took part in that. And he is higher in all of them, you know. After the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the best. Another great part of his life is, Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala never bow down before idols, even before he accepted Islam. One day his father took him to the temple. And his father, Sayyiduna Abu Quhafa, who later on became a Muslim, told his son that these are our gods, idols, you know. So prostrate before them. Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala came in front and he said that, O idols, I am hungry, give me food, feed me. I am naked, cover my body. I need so and so, fulfill my wish. Then he says, if you have anything to help others, then I'm going to heat stone on you, protect yourself. Then Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, whose father got anger, and he called his hand and took him back to the home and told his mother that he went crazy. Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, on whose mother, he told his father that leave him in her, on his own position, because when he was born, I heard a voice. When he was born, I heard a voice. Ya Amat Allah ala Tahqiq, Abshiri bil Walad al Atiq, Ismuhu fi Samai Siddiq, li Muhammadin Sahibun wa Rafiq. Subhanallah. She says, I heard these words when he was born. Somebody was telling me, Ya Amat Allah, O female slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, glad tidings for you, Ismuhu fi Samai, you gave a birth to a boy. His name in the heaven is Siddiq, and he will be Rafiq. He will be great companion and friend of my beloved Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So she says, leave him in on his own position, you know. So Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala was a great companion. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala was a so pious and humble person. One day, by mistake, you know, by mistake, he ate something from his slave's money. He ate something. And after that, when he reminded about that, just he put his hand, he put his finger in the truth and he took it back and vomited, you know. So nothing haram can go inside the body of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala. Because when we eating haram, our du'as and our supplications are not accepted. I'm not telling you. Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam mentioned, one day Sayyidina Sa'ad ibn Abi Waqqas radiyallahu ta'ala, great companion, from those 10 companions who given glad tidings to go Jannah from the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Sa'ad ibn Abi Waqqas radiyallahu ta'ala says, oh Messenger of Allah, pray for me that Allah make me among those whose dua always are accepted. Pray for me that Allah make me among those people righteous whose dua always are accepted. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that, oh Sa'ad, eat halal food, inshallah, always Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your dua. Subhanallah. Eat halal food, always Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your dua and your supplication. So respected brothers and sisters, Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala vomited outside, you know. No haram luqma can go inside the body. So make sure. Seek halal sustenance and halal provision. Always we must make dua. Allahumma rzuqna halalan tayyiba. Allahumma rzuqna halalan tayyiba. Allahumma rzuqna halalan tayyiban wasi'an wa rizqan wasi'an. Oh Allah, grant me, bestow me halal sustenance and pure sustenance. And avoid me from haram sustenance and haram provision. Inshallah, your dua always will be accepted. By the tongue of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it says, respected brothers and sisters, when he passed away, few hours before, he told Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha that, oh my daughter, this one female camel whose milk I used to drink, you know, and this little ball in which I used to eat my food, it is from Baitul Mal. Indeed. Previous time, you know, they used to build Baitul Mal to gather government money, you know, from the Zakat money and all of this kind of money. When they used to get boti and thing from the Bachal, they used to put that, all of that money from in Baitul Mal, and they used to help poor, needy people from that money. But the governor who used to lead them also, one share was of his share, you know, he can take from, because he used to lead the people every time, you know. So Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala says that these two things, female camel and one little ball, it is not halal for my relative after me. So when I will die, transfer it to Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiyallahu ta'ala, because he is the Khalif after me. So it is halal for him in whatever reason, in whatever for whatever he want to spend, that is upon him, you know. But transfer it for Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiyallahu ta'ala. It is not haram and permissible for my relative after me. This was piety. This was taqwa, you know. We are doing so many things, but when coming to the piety and taqwa, just we using that word, you know. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us truthful person. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us halal sustenance. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ability and tawfiq to follow the footsteps of this great companion, Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala. Respected brothers and sisters, Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala was a great. So many things I could share about him, you know. But inshallah, when Muharram lectures we will have, inshallah, I will share much more about him. Because last Friday and this Friday I spoke about him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept these efforts. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us in the company of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Who will go to Jannatul Firdaus. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.